But looking at the markets, it's been a week since the May supply demand report, and you say analysts are still debating what they should make of it.
They are, Artis, particularly when it comes to cotton, and we'll start today with some of OA Cleveland's thoughts about it. Meanwhile, those same reports were definitely pegged as bearish as far as soybeans. Rice plantings in Mississippi could be the smallest in 36 years, while cattle placements in the U.S. may be up sharply. Ag economist OA Cleveland says to expect a continuation of the nervousness and volatility that's been seen in the cotton market since last month. He told AgFacts.com this market appears very much locked within its 82 to 84 cent support at the low end and 88 to 89 cent level on the top end. Meanwhile, Doan's commentary says other key factors at play in cotton right now are the Chinese pushing their old product onto their domestic market out of a massive stockpile, as well as the USDA's forecast of a huge increase in inventory for 2013-14. Commodities in general this week have been under pressure as the U.S. dollar index continues to rally as of our production time. Now for soybeans, the May 10th supply-demand reports added to that pressure as those new numbers were seen by a majority of analysts as bearish for the new crop. Trader Virgil Robinson says producers need to recognize that both U.S. and world soybean supplies are getting larger now, at least on paper.
The theme here is, in a year's time, we swing from unusually tight stocks of soybeans in the U.S. to what is projected to be more comfortable supplies. That was, I think, accentuated by the fact that global supplies are forecast to increase significantly season over season. So please understand and acknowledge that as you think about your new crop, should you have little or nothing priced.
The government is confirming that the 2013-2014 U.S. rice crop is going to be a small one. Now in Mississippi, as well as many other states, that is expected to be the case. Louisiana and Texas are said to be the only exceptions. USDA analysts are concluding that the year-to-year decline is largely due to more favorable expected returns for some alternative crops, especially winter wheat and corn in the Delta. Mississippi's projected 120,000 acres of rice will be almost 8% below a year ago and the smallest plantings in 36 years. Arkansas, meanwhile, is projected to have the smallest rice crop there in some 24 years. Separating the states of Arkansas and Mississippi is a big river, one by the same name as the Magnolia State, and our trivia quiz this week deals with this important transportation link for agriculture. And here is the quiz question. What is the deepest point on the Mississippi River? Is the answer A, St. Louis, or B, Memphis, C, Vicksburg, or D, New Orleans? You'll find out the right choice before our new feature story. On Friday afternoon, May 17th, the government released its monthly cattle on feed report. Livestock analysts had some definite expectations about what that report might show as far as the beef sector. I asked Extension Ag economist Dr. Brian Williams some questions about his pre-report thoughts at midday on Thursday.
Brian, what are we expecting the new on-feed report to show as far as placements and marketings?
Well, right now the expectations are for the placements to be about 12% higher than they were a year ago. A lot of that comes back to extremely low placements that we saw in April a year ago. In terms of marketing, we're expected to be about 3% higher than last year, and total cattle on feed, we're expected to be about 4% lower than last year.
And again, 1 year ago, that was about a 10-year low as far as kind of hitting the very bottom here. All right, as far as total number of cattle on feed, the nation's herd right now, where are we, would you say, in terms of history?
Well, we're seeing a little bit of a downward trend, but not an all-time low. Mm-hmm. If the expectations are correct, we're expecting about 10.7 million cattle to be found to be on feed for the month. Mm-hmm. And the last time that it was this low was in 2010, when it was about 10.5 million.
Okay, now, as we talk about the importance of feed, factoring into livestock, and especially, of course, beef, the term stabilizing has been used as far as corn prices in particular. What impact are we likely to see here as we continue along here, and if indeed they are stabilizing or going lower?
Well, we're seeing a lot of positive news for our feedlots right now. Corn has been coming down since about March, mid-March or so. We've seen the corn prices come down, and that's really going to help the feedlots on their bottom line. And old crop right now is trading for about $6.50. The way it's looking right now, when we get into the new crop, it's going to be even lower than that.
And again, right now we do seem to have a disconnect. Retail beef price is very high, but towards the farm gate, it's not that way in the futures market.
Yeah, there is kind of a distance between the actual retail prices, and I think a lot of that's demand driven. We're starting to see the weather warm up across the country. We're starting to see consumers firing up the grill a little bit more, and so we're seeing the demand come along pretty well compared to the last month or so.
Some analysts are describing the hog market these days as a hard one to call. The last couple of weeks or so, animal weights in the hog sector have set records in the U.S. compared to a year ago, and the government's official hogs and pigs report back in March showed the number of animals up 1.5%. Analyst Naomi Bloom says this market is likely to have a sideways trade for at least the immediate future.
So we have more animals, higher weights, obviously more production, and the exports haven't been as strong as they've been in weeks and years past. So there's potentially more supply on the market, and definitely demand coming because of the grilling season, in theory, coming, and hopefully we'll see it continue, but all right, sideways for now.
Before our feature story, let's look at the trivia answer for this week. The correct choice is D. The deepest section is in New Orleans near Algiers Point. It's about 200 feet deep.